We'll be looking at exponential decay. If you haven't already viewed the video on exponential growth, I would highly recommend that. Our objectives are to find a function that satisfies the equation dp dt equal to negative kp, convert between decay rate and half-life, and solve applied problems involving exponential decay. The equation dp dt equal to negative kp, or k greater than 0, shows p to be decreasing as a function of time, and the solution, p of t equal to p naught times e to the negative kt power, shows to be decreasing exponentially. This is exponential decay. Here's a graph of exponential decay. Notice that as we progress from left to right, the graph goes down exponentially. An exponential decay model is a function of the form p of t equal to p naught times e to the power of negative kt. P naught is the quantity present at time 0, p of t is the amount present at time t, and k is the decay rate. The half-life is the amount of time necessary for half of the quantity to decay. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example. Carbon 14 has a decay rate of 0.01205% per year. The rate of change of any amount n of carbon 14 is given by the derivative of n with respect to t is equal to negative 0.0001205n. The connection again here, if this is the decay rate, the derivative is going to be equal to negative k, the decay rate, times the function. One thing to remember is that when they give you the percentage, of course, in this form, it's going to be in decimal form. Using n of t equal to n naught times e to the negative k t power, find the exponential function that models the situation. So often they change around these variables, but essentially they mean the same thing. So for this problem, the connection we need to make is that n of t is equal to n sub 0 times e to the negative, there's our k, 0.0001205t. This is our exponential decay model. Using this function, address the following questions. Suppose that 200 grams of carbon 14 is present at time equals 0. How much will remain after 800 years? Well, we need to find n of 800. N sub 0 is our starting amount, which of course would be 200 grams. Essentially, we need to substitute 800 for t. Let's go ahead and do this. We need to be a little careful when we type this in. 200 second natural log brings up the e. Now our exponent is negative 0.0001205 times 800. And we can see it's going to be 181.62 grams. We can see with the decay rate, which is so small, that after 800 years, there's still a considerable amount left. The next question, after how many years will half of 200 grams of carbon 14 remain? Well, for half-life, that means half remains. So we have 100 grams left if we start with 200 grams. And we have to solve this equation for t. So we need to divide by 200. This is very similar to what we were doing when we were solving exponential growth problems. So on the left side now, we have 1 half is equal to e And as we know before, if we take the natural log of both sides, we can apply the power property of logs. So when we rewrite this, now I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this as natural log 1 minus natural log 2. Equal to and this would be times natural log e. Now doing some simplifying here, this is equal to 0 natural log 1 and times natural log e, but natural log e is equal to 1. So this simplifies fairly nicely into negative natural log 2 equal to negative 0.00012 0.00012 t. Now notice that both sides are negative, so if we multiplied both sides by a negative 1, we could make both sides positive. Now the reason I want to point that out, because you can see what we have left here is natural log 2 equal to 0.00012 0.00012 t. Again, we have natural log 2 is equal to k times t. That idea will appear here in just a moment. Simplifying here, of course, we need to divide by the coefficient of t. It's a little bit small. Apologize for that. Our value of t will be approximately 5,752.26 years. So as we can see, it takes a considerable amount of time in order for carbon-14 to decay to half of its starting amount.